Hello and welcome to Before Exams. Here we help you to prepare for your competitive examinations. Subscribe to our channel so that whenever we post the content about your exam, you get the notification about it. Hello and welcome to this section of IELTS reading. In this section, we'll be talking about the summary completion question. So in these type of questions, there is a passage and then a summary given. What you have to do is there are gaps in that summary. You have to fill that gaps by looking at the passage, by finding the information from the passage. So what all we'll be learning here, first we'll be checking what skills are tested in these kind of questions, the common problems that a candidate face. Then they will be talking about some tips and tricks to attempt these kind of questions, and then a strategy, how you can go ahead and how you can attempt these questions. Also, we'll be talking about the example. We'll be taking an example of these type of question. So the skills which are tested in these kind of questions are, first is the ability to skim and scan the passage quickly. Now the difficulty level of these kind of questions is pretty easy, and the probability of the question coming in the test paper is 1/2, which is 50%. So many a times you find this question in your examination. Now, the thing is, you have to have the ability to skim and scan the passage quickly. It is because there are a series of questions. You need to find the gaps of that summary from the passage. So you need to find around 8 to 9 gaps. And then the thing is that you need to do it very quickly. So as you have to attempt the questions quickly, you have to skim and scan the passage. You should have the ability to skim and scan the passage. That is to get the clear understanding of the summary of the passage. Then understanding the general meaning of the text is what is required. Now, in this kind of question, the understanding of whole text is not required. What students do is they make a mistake that they try to read the whole text and they try to read the understand the meaning of the whole text, but that is not required. But what is required is just the understanding of the general meaning, that what is the general meaning, what is the summary of this text, what is the summary of the passage. Then ability to figure out synonyms. Obviously, there are a lot of synonyms that you need to figure out. What you see is you see some words there in the passage. What you have to do is you have to figure out that what are the synonyms of those words. And using that synonyms, you have to find the answers. Obviously, identifying keywords is the key skill here, because if you'll not be able to identify the keywords, you'll not be able to attempt the question. That is, you'll not be able to get the answer very easily and also very quickly. So identifying keywords is the most important part here. If you identify the keywords very well, if you are able to do that very well, it will become a cakewalk for you to attempt these kind of questions. Let's just see that what are the common problems that a candidate face. Now, in these kind of questions, candidate often waste the time reading and getting detailed information, as I was explaining. What candidate does is, he or she reads the whole passage and tries to get the detailed information, and then he or she tries to attempt the summary. But this is not the case here. You just need to get the basic idea, the summary, what it is talking about. So you can just answer that. It is just that you need to find the information, what you have to answer, and you need to read that only. You do not need to understand the whole passage. So in this, you are only required to get an understanding of the summary of the passage. Now, many candidates just fill up the gap, ignoring the basic rules of grammar. So in these kind of gaps, either one word, two word, or three words are there. That is, there could be a phrase also. So many a time what student does is they just look at the passage and they try to fit in those words or the phrases which they think is the correct answer. But a lot of times it happens that it is not the correct answer because it is not grammatically correct. Now, if it is not grammatically correct, always remember that it is not the correct answer. It is the incorrect answer that you are thinking it is the answer. So if it is grammatically incorrect, you have to do it again. You just think that this is the wrong answer. You have to do it again and you have to check for the right answer here. Other thing, candidates here try to find the same words in the text message. Now, there is a skill which is tested here, which is the knowledge of synonyms. What the candidate does, they find the keyword from the question or the summary, and then they find the same keywords in the passage, or they find some keywords in the passage and they find to they try to find the same keyword, that the same words in the questions or the summary. But this is not the case. Synonyms are used here. So you always have to be open about the usage of synonyms. So this is what, which is the most important, the crucial part, most crucial part of IELTS reading test. You need to have a lot of knowledge about synonyms and identifying the keywords. That is why I say it a lot of times, that you need to have knowledge of this, and this can come only by practice. So you have to practice a lot of reading passages to develop this habit of identifying the synonyms and the keywords. This will really boost up your speed to find the answers. Because as I always say, everyone will be able to find every answer of the passage. The only thing is about the time. You have to find it in a stipulated time limit. Right? So this can be done by synonyms. This is the best way to identify the answer. You need to be open about the synonyms. Then let's talk about the tips and tricks that you need to keep in mind while attempting these questions. Now, if the answer is grammatically incorrect, the answer is incorrect, as I have been telling you. If you think, if when you fit that and you fit that in the gap and you realize that it is not grammatically correct, then you just understand that it is the grammatically incorrect answer, or it is the incorrect answer. Then always think of possible synonyms of the keywords and look for the synonyms in the text. So whenever you find a keyword in the summary or in the text, always use the possible synonyms. Always think of the possible synonyms and then try to find those synonyms from the text. If you're not able to find an answer, don't waste a lot of time. Just guess the answer and move on. Because you have to attempt a lot of questions in a stipulated time. That is around 50 to 55 minutes. You have to attempt 40 questions. So you do not have a lot of time. So if you are not able to find the answer of a question or of a gap, just leave it. Just guess it. Guessing is important because there is no negative marking here. So even if that answer is wrong, you won't lose anything. But if the answer is correct, you will gain one mark, which is really helpful in jumping to the next band score. So in case you are not able to find an answer, never waste a lot of time. Always guess the answer and just move on to the next question, which could be a simpler question. Answers are in the same order in the text. Now in the summary type of questions, answer will be in the order. So let's say if you find the answer of first question in the third line of a paragraph, that means you won't find the answer of the second question above it. You will find it always the third line. It is only always after the third line. So it is always recommended to look for the answers after the previous answer. It is because the answers are always in order here. Now, in summary completion type of questions, there are two types of questions which are asked. One is a summary, and then there are gaps. You need to fill up the gaps, finding the gaps from the passage. The other thing is that the type of question is, there will be a summary wherein there will be gaps, and then there will be a table in which a list of answers will be there. You need to pick out the answers from there. So this is what you can do. What you can do here is, for the question where options are given, always try to eliminate the incorrect answers. I'll be telling it to you in a better way when we'll be looking at the example. Always try to eliminate. By just looking at those options, there will be many options which you will think that this is not the correct answer, and that you can eliminate. Now, specifically in the questions wherein options are given, and in this type of questions, that is the summary completion questions, predict the answer before looking in the text. Because predicting is easy. And if you will predict the answer, it will be easy for you to figure out the answer from the passage which is given. So these are some of the tips and tricks that you need to keep in mind while attempting the summary completion questions. Look, now we'll just go ahead and we'll look at the strategy, that how you should go ahead and how you should attempt these questions. Step one is, read the question carefully. That is, always read that summary carefully and make a note of the keywords. Then skim the passage and figure out the overall meaning of the passage. In this, you do not have to get the clear understanding. Just understand that what is the overall meaning of the passage. Let's take an example. If it is about tigers, so let's just see that what they are talking about tigers, whether they are talking about their food habits, whether they are talking about their shelter, whether they are talking about the different processes they go through while they are born. So it could be a series of topics which could be there about tiger. So what you just figure out that what they are talking about in general, this will really help you to figure out the answers. Because when you will be figuring out the answers from the passage, it will help you to figure out which information is given in which paragraph of that whole text or that whole passage. So you will just look at that paragraph and it will help you to find the answers from there. Then for the list of word type of questions, try to zero down 2 to 3 options before trying to find the answers from the group. That is, or from the text, what you have to do is there will be a list of words which will be given. So eliminate the words from the list and try to zero down the words to 2 to 3 options. Many a time it could be the case that you can find the correct option just by guessing and without looking at the passage. But try to zero down to 2 to 3 options, because when you will zero it down to 2 to 3 options when you'll be reading the passage or skimming and scanning the passage, it will be a cakewalk for you to find the answer from there. Then try finding the answer from the part of the passage the summary relates to, as I've already told. So always try to find the answer from the part of the passage the summary relates to. Now this summary most of the times will not be of the full passage or the text. It will be either of 2 to 3 paragraphs, either 2 or 3 paragraphs. So try to find the answers from those 2 to 3 paragraphs only. Always check in the fill up kind of questions or gap kind of questions. Always check if it is grammatically correct. If it is not, then it is not the correct answer. And then repeat the steps for the next question. Repeat the same steps for the next question. Now let's just go ahead and look at example. Now I am not giving you a text here to find the answers. This is because I just wanted to give you a glimpse of the type of questions that you will find here. Now, when you will be attempting these type of questions, you will come to know that how you have to attempt this, because we have already done the sentence completion type of questions. The strategy will be same. The only thing is that you just need to have a text here. I haven't given you the text because I just wanted to give you an idea what these questions are. So this is the kind of question wherein the list of keywords is not given. You need to just figure out the answer. Although the main tenets of every meal are dash and dash. So that means you can now imagine, and now you can go ahead and now you can guess that in this kind of question, there could be some nutrients which they could talk about. Right. So you can look for these keywords and it will be easy for you to find the answers. Got it? Okay. Now, the other type of question is wherein there is a summary and then there is a list which is given of some words. Now, these what you have to do is you can just figure out and you can zero down the list to 2 to 3 words. Let's try to zero it down. Let's see that for the first question or the first fill up, how many words we can zero it down to. The chocolate market is dominated by dash brands. Now, by purchasing brands, can this be the answer? No, this cannot be the answer. By low fat brands, maybe this could be the answer. By selection brands, this is not grammatically correct. So, by media brands, maybe. Impulsive brand. So this is not the answer. By similarly brands, no. Similar brands, if it would have been similar, always remember you have to use the same keyword. So similarly brands could not be the answer. By eating brands, maybe. By outdated brands, maybe. By novelty brands, no. By unsuccessful brands, by well-known brands, by international brands, by new brands, by children's brands, by lasting brands, by temporary brands. So now in this, we were able to eliminate 50% of these options. Now let's just go ahead and let's see. Low fat, media, outdated. Chocolate market is dominated by outdated brands. Can chocolate market be dominated by outdated brands, or any market be dominated by outdated brands? That means if they are outdated, they won't be dominating the market. So this could not be the answer. By unsuccessful brands, chocolate market cannot be dominated by unsuccessful brands. So in this second go, we can eliminate more options. By well-known brands, yes, this would be the answer. By international brands, okay. By new brands, this would be the answer. By children's brands. Now it is talking about chocolate market. Children's brands will be like apparels, footwear. So this cannot be the answer. Now the thing is, there are some other things. Chocolate market cannot be dominated by media brands also. So in first go, what we did, we just figured out that which answers could be grammatically correct. So after that, after just figuring out which are grammatically correct, then we are zeroing it down to 2 to 3 options. So now we have zeroed it down to 1, 2, 3, and 4 options. So we have been able to, out of 1, 2, 3, 4, that is out of 16 options, we were easily able to zero it down to 4 options. So this is how you can go ahead and you can zero it down to 2 to 3 or 4 options. And now it will be very easy for you to find the answers for it, because now you just need to go ahead and you need to look for these keywords. Now you can think that these are the keywords for which you have to look for the answer. So you will be going ahead and you will be looking for these keywords, and this will help you out to figure out the answer. I hope you get it now. I hope this is clear to you now, right? Now, what you have to do is, for the assignment, you can always mail me to the email address, on the email address which is given in the description. I'll be sending you the assignment. You can attempt that, and then we'll be looking at what is the feedback on that assignment, what you could have done to improve your score. Okay, so this will be it for now. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for watching this video lecture. I hope you really enjoyed it and you learned a lot. Thank you and have a great day. Bye-bye.